The blind and poor guy of today's gospel symbolizes our spiritually blind and poor humanity, which Christ came to save and heal from the darkness of sin. The Lord Jesus Christ is the true light who enlightens and sanctifies everyone who comes into the world. And he awaits to hear from us just a single, Lord Jesus Christ, have mercy on me, the sinner, so he can enlighten the darkness of our souls, to enlighten the blindness of our minds. People without Christ, without the light of the world, we are spiritually blind. We don't know where we come from or where we're going. There are people who may live away from Christ in the darkness of sin, but their soul is desperately trying to escape, to find an opening to light, to find God, to see heaven. They're the ones who, for one reason or another, they can't help themselves. They remain suffocated in this darkness, spiritually blind, but they're the ones who sooner or later, they're going to cry out with all the strength of their soul, I want to see Lord, just like the blind man of today's gospel did. And they will see. The prayers of these fellow human beings, who may sound annoying to some others, will definitely be answered. However, today's gospel also reveals a tragic contrast, the spiritual blindness of the people who are next to Christ, his faithful followers and admirers, those who prevented the blind man from approaching Christ and asked him to be silent, those who, while they could see the daily light and could tell the difference between day and night, were unable to discern the message of love in Christ's gospel and were indifferent to the drama of their neighbor. People of faith who follow Christ but ignore and do not listen to the blind fellow man who begs and cries for help. Faith without love is like a useless gift. People who pride themselves on their religiousness and who should be shining examples of love that inspire and lead other people on God's path, they're indifferent and unmoved by human suffering. People who, while not blind, are steeped in their own spiritual darkness, people whose eyes may be open, but whose hearts remain closed. Faith without love is demonic. Demons believe as well, but have no trace of love whatsoever. Faith without love is the reason why the world experiences holy wars and terrible crimes. It is the reason why people turn away and isolate themselves from God. We must understand that we cannot have God in our hearts when the heart within has no love for our fellow men. The way to heaven is through our fellow men. It is unheard of that there are faithful Christians who follow Christ, who live the sacraments of the Church, whose mouths are stuffed with adidoro and Holy Communion, and yet they condemn their fellow human beings and consider them unworthy to come close to Christ. And even worse, they try to prevent them from approaching him, as they did with the blind man of today's gospel. Brothers and sisters in Christ, let us be watchful. If we notice that we judge other people, if we consider ourselves better than others, or even worse, if we do not care about their problems and do not want to help them, we must realize that all these are not Christian behaviors, but the symptoms of pride and spiritual blindness. Our Lord Jesus Christ cares and humbly embraces every single one of us, every person, every sinner, every blind, and asks something that we may never ask our fellow human beings. What do you want me to do for you? What matters is only our love. No matter how much faith and knowledge we may have, we cannot give light. We cannot perform miracles. We cannot make anyone see physically or spiritually. But if we have love, then at least we cannot be indifferent. We care and we can be there for others. Even if we have nothing special, intelligent or spiritual to say to them, we can smile at them. We can show concern. And that concern is the most beautiful gesture of love we could ever offer. That concern is a light in the tunnel. It is a ray of light in the cloudy soul of our hurting fellow people. And this light of hope is a very great miracle itself. Although the greatest miracle is that this love is what makes all Christians the light of the world. Amen.